This is my very first Dutch pour that I am going to make. Here's the colors I'm using. Jet black, white, purple pansy, lilac mist, and pale daffodil. So I don't really have a good way to put my phone, but at least you'll be able to see a little bit of what I'm doing. Hopefully this turns out really good. Since I've never done this before, I'm not really sure how much paint to put on here, but we will find out. This might not be enough paint. Okay. Not really sure if that's a good idea either, but we're learning, so we're gonna find out. Probably not, because there's a lot of spaces that now don't have paint on them. And so even as I'm trying to go off of the edges, it's not gonna do it. Not like I need it to. So I probably should have just left well enough alone and left it in the center. Well, we're learning, right? I may have actually made it that I'm gonna waste more paint this way than I would have the other way. I was hoping to be able to drip some back into the cup, but I don't think that's going to work. Ah, shoot. Well, guess this is why it's called a learning curve. Not really sure what I need to do. Maybe. Okay. Just a little more paint along the edge. And tip it that way so it can go off of the edge. So that side's pretty good. So unfortunately, this means that I'm not going to have enough paint made up for my next one of the black. Because it wasn't going to use as much black, but I still needed black for it, so. Sure, gets the whole side. It's not even getting the whole top, so I don't know that it's getting the whole side. Nope, it's not. So, we're going to do this. It's okay. I don't mind if it's not perfect. It's my first one, and it's still going to be awesome learning how to do this. just kind of feels like I'm trying to put frosting on a cake. So I'm definitely going to have to figure out a better way to hold on to this thing. Because I know I'm messing up the edges as I'm doing this. Fingers were. I put thumbtacks on the bottom of it, hoping that that would work well enough, but I mean it holds it up off of the floor, but it's still... Still didn't make it easier for me to hold it from the underside like I was hoping it would. Alright, so the edge of this is kind of rough, not the best, but there's that part now. I got to experiment with using a butane torch because I've never used one before. So that'll be fun. Alright. Yeah, the edge of this is not good. Read the instructions for using the torch, so hopefully I got this. Okay, I don't know why the flame went out. I don't really know how close I need to get it or anything. I'm supposed to use this so that it pops any bubbles that are hidden in the paint. It said that you will get little tiny bubbles all over and you won't know it until it's drying. Not really sure. I see something happening anyway. But I don't know if it's just this torch spitting or what. Hopefully it's actually doing what it's supposed to be doing. Well, this looks interesting. Okay, so I haven't quite decided how I want to do the other colors on here yet, since I don't know what they're going to look like, but we'll just try it and see. I'm not really sure if I want to do lines on it, or if I want to do one in the center, or what. So, I think, let's see. I'm going to do a little bit of white first. I think that will help. Mixing with the black. Well, okay. hoping it wouldn't do that, but it did, so it's alright. This is why this is my experimental one. Because I'm just not sure what it's going to do. Let's try this and find out, shall we? Don't know if I should put more white on it, or if I should just call it good. Maybe I'll just call it good. Oh. I was forgetting. So somebody was saying that you torch it because it makes it so that your stuff will move. Now I can't think of the right word. It breaks the barrier though, so it'll move like it needs to. Okay, this is not working like I thought it would. So, what am I gonna do now? Do a bit more layering. Now I feel like I have an awful lot of paint on here. So hopefully, it will still turn out right. Alright. Torch it again. One of the things the torching does is if you have paints that are heavier than other paints, it will allow them to come up to the surface, so you don't just have one particular one that's on the surface and the other ones don't work. Alright, I guess that's good enough, hopefully. Alright, let's try this again. Well, it's not quite what I had thought it might look like, but I think it's going to turn out okay. Here's what it looks like. It's kind of hard to tell since there's so much black on the plastic underneath it, but I think it's going to be okay.